Hi everyone, it's Luke, and today I'm going to show you how to install Mac OS X on your PC using VirtualBox. So let's begin. So what you need to run the Mac operating system on your Windows desktop is a copy of the Mountain Lion operating system. And then you need VirtualBox, which is a free virtualization software from Oracle. Or you can use something like VMware, that also works. And the reason that someone would want to do this is either to perhaps run Xcode and develop iOS apps or Mac apps on their Windows machine, or just to test out different websites using a different platform, or to even try out a Mac and see how you feel about it. So let's go ahead and show you where you can get that CD. So you do need to go to a torrent site like the Pirate Bay, and what you want to search for is IATKOS. That's what you type in, IATKOS, and then I just sorted by the most number of CDs. So something like this: Mac OS X Mountain Lion 10.8.2. Doesn't really matter if it's the latest version or not, because you can upgrade it later. You do need to have a BitTorrent client installed in order to do this, but if you do have it, go ahead and download it. It'll take you a while, and when you're done, we can continue. I've already done this, so we don't need to do that, so I'm going to minimize my my window here. The next thing you need to do is install VirtualBox, and I've done that, so I'm just going to start it up. And if you don't have it, you can just go to your browser and search for VirtualBox and download the latest version and install it. It's a free download, and it doesn't take up a lot of room on your system. And it works really well, so I would highly recommend it. If you have VMware, that also works, but it'll cost you some money. So you may want to give VirtualBox a try. It's a great program to virtualize Linux, Windows, different versions of Windows, DOS, and what have you. So once you've downloaded and installed VirtualBox, go ahead and make a new virtual machine by clicking the New button. And we're going to name our machine My Mac. You can call it whatever you want, frankly. But I'm going to call it My Mac. And based on the name, VirtualBox should be able to detect if you named it with Mac, the type of operating system. But if you named it something else, just click on the drop-down list and select Mac OS, OS X, and then select which version you want to install, either the generic just 64-bit OS X or like the Mountain Lion specific one. I'm going to go ahead and click on OS X 10.8 Mountain Lion, because that's what I have. Click Next. Give it a decent amount of RAM. My Windows box is just a basic desktop i7 processor with 12 megs of RAM. I don't have anything else running right now except for the screencast recorder. So I'm going to allocate, I don't know, maybe 6400 meg of RAM. That's just a little over 6 gig. And that should be plenty. Even 4 gigs is plenty. I have a MacBook Air and it comes default with 4 gigs and it runs fine. But be a little generous if you can afford it, because it'll just make the machine a little bit better. The next step is to create a virtual hard drive where you'll store your operating system and the install. And basically, it's just one big file that resides in your hard drive that's then used as a virtual hard disk. So I'm going to select the option to create the drive now. Click Create. And it asks you for a bunch of hard drive formats. So the default is the VirtualBox disk image, but you can see here that it supports virtual hard disk for VMware, for Parallels, for QEMU, but we're going to leave it at the default. We're fine with that. Click Next. And then this option allows you to either fix the size immediately or to expand it as necessary, which is the default option, dynamically allocated. That just means that as you use it and the drive gets larger, the physical file that's acting as the virtual drive will also grow. If you select fixed size, and let's say you make a virtual hard disk that's 100 gigs, it's going to reserve 100 gigs immediately on your hard drive. And if you don't have that free, that's not going to work. So we're going to dynamically allocate our drive. Leave that and then click Next. Then you can give it a name. This name is just fine, but you can call it whatever you want. You can even browse to where you want to store the virtual hard drive file. I'm just going to leave everything as default for now. I will up the size of the drive though, because by default it gives you 20 gigs, and that's not going to be enough if you really are going to use this as a working machine to do some kind of work in. So I'm going to up it to, let's say, 128. That's a nice even binary based number. And I'm just going to click Create. Right now, you are almost done, but not quite. We do have to go into settings and kind of tweak some of the default settings that VirtualBox give to the machine before we can boot up. So I click on Settings, and I kind of just work my way from the top down. So in general, I really don't have to do anything here to change the default. It's fine as it is. In System, though, I want to uncheck this box. This is very important. So the one that says Enable EFI, I'm going to get rid of that. Okay. And I'm also going to uncheck the floppy drive because I really don't have a need for that. So I'm just going to kill it right now. And in Processor, I'm going to up the cores from one CPU to two and leave that. Everything else the same. Okay. It's very important to uncheck this, though. You can almost leave everything else, but you need to uncheck this. I will go to into the display and just give my virtual video card a little bit more memory. Let's call it 128 megs. That's pretty good. You can enable this if you want to, but sometimes it's not compatible depending on the operating system that you use, and the VirtualBox may give you an error like this if you select something that's not valid. Okay. So we'll uncheck that. And then the last step really is to go into the storage section and then mount the Mountain Lion install DVD image. So I'm going to click on the DVD drive, and right now it shows empty. Go down over here and I click choose a virtual CD or DVD disk file. You can see here that I have a few that I've used recently. And in fact, it's going to be this one, but I'm just going to go through the process. So I'm just going to click Choose, and it'll default to the location where it's storing your files. And if you also happen to store your downloaded iATCOS ML2 disk image in that location, or if you move it there after it's downloaded, then you can just click on it, click Open. And what that does, you can see that it changes from empty to the name of that disk image. It means that it's going to load that when it starts. So at this point, I'm going to click OK. I don't really need to go through the rest of these. It's fine. So I'm just going to click OK. And then we're going to click Start and get things going. I'm going to go ahead and move this box so that we can see it better. And you can see that it says go ahead and install to press any key to install, and that's what I'm going to do. And right now it's booting up the installation media. So iATCOS that you downloaded from BitTorrent is a pirated copy of Mac OS X. There's no way around that. But unless you want to go and buy a copy of Mountain Lion and then hack it yourself to be able to install on a virtual machine or even a Hackintosh, you're kind of out of luck if you don't have that skill. You certainly can, but even then you may be breaking the terms of service. If you're just going to use it and play around, I don't think anybody's going to go after you for downloading this. So once it boots up and it starts the install, you're going to see this screen. You can select a bunch of languages. We're going to leave it as English and click Next. And it tells you that to install, you click continue, and that's what we're going to do. It asks you if you agree. And you're actually agreeing to the IATCO's installation media more than anything else. But we agree. And right now, you can see that it says select the disk where you want to install IATCO's Mountain Lion 2, and it's empty. See that? So what we have to do is we have to click on the menu here, Utilities, and go into Disk Utility. Because we created a hard drive in our virtual machine, but we haven't partitioned it yet. So here's our virtual hard drive, and it looks a little bit bigger than I remember making it, but that's fine. Go into the Partition tab, click on the plus button, give this guy a name. Let's call it Mac OS X. You can call it whatever you want. The default format of Mac OS Extended Journal is great. It's perfect. Click Apply. It's going to ask you, you're going to lose data, blah, blah, blah. Do you really want to? And we do. We want to create this partition, so click Partition. And after a very short while, the partition is created. You can actually see it right here under the virtual hard drive. Now we can quit the disk utility. And voila, you have a drive here that you can install on. So we click on that, and it gives you this option that it's going to install there. You can either change items by clicking Customize or click Install. Let's go ahead and just customize it a little bit. What I'm going to do is I'm going to lose the IATCO's boot logo by going into Bootloader Options. And then I'm going to check this original Apple logo, okay? Because that's what I want. You can look at different options to see what it does. So for example, this other one, the Quiet Boot, I'm going to check that as well. And that's probably the only two that I'm going to check. If you want to customize this to your needs and you want to really explore what it can do, you're free to read the installation guide for IATCOs and figure out what all of these options do. But for me, these two are more than enough. I'm going to click OK and I'm going to click Install. So right now, it's going to go through the installation process. It's going to take a bit of time, maybe not the full 14 minutes, but it's going to take a bit of time. So I'm going to let it run and I'm going to come back when the installation is completed and show you how to proceed from there. So we'll let that run. All right, so now we're back. The install has completed and you can see that it says you have to restart your computer in order to use the Mac. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to power off the machine. And you can either do that by clicking on the close button or going to machine and selecting shut down. Because when you click close, it's going to ask you, do you want to save the state, send the shutdown signal, or power off the machine? I'm just going to power off the machine. It won't harm it at this point. Click OK. You're back in the main VirtualBox application. And you want to go back into settings. And the reason we want to do this is we want to go in here and remove the Mountain Lion boot disk, the install disk. So I'm going to select the CD drive and I say remove disk from virtual drive. So that still leaves the DVD drive, but it just won't load a disk image. Click OK and click Start. You'll notice that this time when we're booting, you see the standard Apple logo and not the IATCO's logo. And the background is a solid gray instead of the pattern background that you saw earlier. We'll give it a moment to start up here. And then we'll jump right into configuring the Mac and using it. My little color wheel is spinning. And in post-production, I may jump through this. All right, we are at the welcome screen of my new Mac. And you select your country. I'll leave it at United States. click continue. Choose a keyboard layout, US is fine. And you can transfer information from another Mac if you want to, and I'm going to say not now. You can do it later when you wish to while using that migration assistant, so we'll just say not now. You can enable location services on this Mac, although as a virtual machine, I don't think it will do anything, but let's see, maybe it'll figure it out from the Wi-Fi hotspot or whatever. And at this point, you can also sign in with your Apple ID. I'm not going to do that, so I'm just going to click skip. Again, you can do this later if you want to. It's going to say, you sure? And we say yes. And it's going to ask you if you agree to a bunch of OS X software license agreement. And we say sure, continue. Give it a name. So choose a password. You can give it a hint if you need to, but it's not really required. And then you can also see if you need to require a password when logging in or not. We'll just leave that default as is. Click continue. It warns you, but we're just going to continue. If you don't have a hint, it gives you that warning, but it doesn't matter. It's not required. Goes through creating your account. Select your time zone. Click continue. Ask if you want to register. We're going to skip. Are you sure? Of course. And that's it. Start using your Mac. It's going to go through some final configuration settings. And there you are. That's Macintosh. I'm going to go ahead and change the some of the system's options. So I'm going to make my dock magnify as I go back and forth. So we can say magnify. Okay. You can have different effects for windows closing and what have you. We can change the desktop background. So let's say I don't like the default. We can just pick something else. I know that there's a space picture, this one. We'll use that. So pretty much this is your new Mac. So you can do whatever you want. You'll go to the App Store, check for updates, things like that. And that's basically it in a nutshell. The one thing that you want to do after you have it running is to go and search for something called MultiBeast. I think the latest version is called 4.6.1. Once you've downloaded that, it'll help you to tweak some settings of your Mac, because right now you probably won't have sound and some other things. But for the most part, it should work just fine, and if you want to use it to develop an Xcode and what have you, it's going to help you to do that, and you don't need a lot more than the basic setup here. But if you want to tweak it, download MultiBeast and go through the options, read the user guide. But that's pretty much it. Good luck, guys.